Senator, it's the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. You know, this legislation, when originally passed, was about chasing ghosts, from my point of view. You know, when people want to commit election fraud, they don't do it one vote at a time. They do it as a big group. And the idea that somebody's going to go and fake somebody's ID just to vote is nonsensical. But beyond all that, the reason President, that this legislation...
I had asked the senator would yield.
I'll yield.
Well, senator, yield.
Mr.
Floor.
President, I would ask whether the senator is familiar with a case just, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago. I guess it was a little longer than that because it was before I was in the Senate, in which a member of the Senate of Virginia was caught and charged with voting for somebody else.
Senator, the floor.
I'm not familiar with him, but I hope he went to jail and isn't part of this body anymore.
Is not a member of this body, but I would point out to the gentleman that his claim that it never happens is belied by the truth.
Okay, well, I hope he didn't cast a vote in the Yancey race a couple years ago. But in any event, listen, the reason this legislation doesn't, or the existing system doesn't work, is because not everybody has a license or access to photo ID. All right, I emailed the commissioner of the Department of Motor Vehicles this morning, and I asked him how many people today are suspended in Virginia. But thanks to Senator Stanley's work and the governor's work, that number is thankfully down. The last time I asked, it was over 800,000. Today, it's down to 333,820 people whose licenses are suspended. What happens when your license is suspended? If you happen to run into a police officer, they take it. What happens in the building that I go to work in every day when I'm at home? I see about 100, 200 licenses trading hands from people to the government every day. And if you're one of those lucky people that happens to be in court within a week or two or three of when you have to vote, you're not going to have your government ID because somebody's going to be holding it for you. And the idea that somebody's going to go get an ID just so they can vote isn't really realistic. And so a lot of those people don't have their ID because they either got suspended, they broke the law, I get it. But just because you got a reckless driving ticket and had your license taken by a judge doesn't mean you shouldn't be able to vote. Secondly, there's 28 nuns in my district. They live in this monastery up on a hill. They don't even wear shoes every day. And I guarantee you they don't have photo ID because they just don't drive. They've taken a vow of poverty. You want to disenfranchise nuns? Vote red. Let me tell you two other stories. Back when I ran the first time in 2009, I was knocking doors. I ran to this woman named Mildred Downing. Mildred was 96 years old. And she told me she'd vote for me. And I asked her if she needed a ride to the polls. And she's like, no, I don't need a ride. I was out there working outside Stratford Precinct, shaking hands. Car pulls up. Mildred gets out of the car with her walker and walks up to me and says, I told you I'd vote, and I'm here. You know what? Mildred didn't have a driver's license, I'm pretty sure, because she's 96 years old. I don't know many 96-year-olds that have a driver's license as much as anybody that lets them keep them. In that same election, number four, I was knocking doors right next to my high school, West Potomac High School. When I was looking at my voter file, I was talking to this man. He was 83 years old. I was having a conversation with him. He committed to vote for me. And I looked at the sheet, and it said on my sheet, I looked at him and I said, my voter sheet here says that there's a person in this house who's 105 years old. He's like, hey, that's my mom, Maddie Lou. She's sitting right there. And there was a woman sitting in this chair, 105 years old, Maddie Lou Ware. And I asked her if I could have her vote. She nodded and said, yeah. And it turned out that she had registered to vote because she wanted to vote for President Obama. She'd gotten out of the House, gotten down to register, and made the effort to vote. But I guarantee you this 105-year-old woman did not have a driver's license and probably didn't have photo ID. So, you know, there it is. If you want to disenfranchise people that just have the bad luck to go to court, you want to disenfranchise nuns, you want to disenfranchise 90-year-olds, 100-year-olds, vote red, be my guest. But this bill will allow everybody in Virginia to vote because if you're a citizen, you make it to 100 years old, you ought to be able to vote. And I think we ought to vote this through.
For what purpose, Senator from Western Fairfax, Senator Mars?